His charm is so contagious, vaccines have been created for it. Years ago, he built a city out of blocks. Today, over 600,000 people live and work there. He is the only man to ever ace a Rorschach test. Every time he goes for a swim, dolphins appear. Alien abductors have asked him to probe them. If he were to give you directions, you'd never get lost, and you'd arrive at least 5 minutes early. His legend precedes him, the way lightning precedes thunder. He is the most interesting man in the world. People hang on his every word, even the prepositions. He could disarm you with his looks, or his hands, either way. He can speak French, in Russian. He is the most interesting man in the world. He is the life of parties he has never attended. If he were to punch you in the face, you would have to fight off the strong urge to thank him. Sharks have a week dedicated to him. He is the most interesting man in the world. His reputation is expanding faster than the universe. He once had an awkward moment, just to see how it feels. He lives vicariously through himself. He is the most interesting man in the world.
He's been known to cure narcolepsy just by walking into a room. His organ donation card also lists his beard. He's a lover, not a fighter, but he's also a fighter, so don't get any ideas. He is the most interesting man in the world. His personality is so magnetic, he is unable to carry credit cards. Even his enemies list him as their emergency contact number. He never says something tastes like chicken, not even chicken. He is the most interesting man in the world.
He has amassed an incredibly large DVD library, and it is said that he never once alphabetized it. If he were to mail a letter without postage, it would still get there. When it is raining, it is because he's thinking about something sad. The pheromones he secretes have been known to affect people miles away in a slight.
He is the most interesting man in the world. His reputation is expanding faster than the universe.
If she's married, it's not your fault. She has a ring on, so what? If you want to bang her, that's totally up to you. So what? If she's married and she has kids, do it in front of them. Who cares? Anyway, stay thirsty, my friends, and drink Corona. Woo!
No advertisements.
Woo! Or drink your own. You know what that is, don't you? All right. We'll be right back on the Gorgeous George Show. Woo!
Just like you've done before, and wrap my heart round your little finger. Here you come again.
when I'm about to make it work without you. You look into my eyes and lie those pretty lies, and pretty soon I'm wondering.
Through that underwear, and you ladies out there have a secretion every time you see my face. My name is Henry. I'm the bald old man that ran for president a few times and lost. Had John Kerry as my VP, and then had the guy in prison, and, you know, running for VP with me. I forget his name. Vinny LaRouche. Anyway, it's all said and done. Now, tonight, we're going to talk with former person that ran for president. And he's got bitter prunes about a certain person. His name is John McCain. He ran for president back in 2008. John McCain's in the house tonight. What's going on, Johnny?
It's so good to be here, Henry. There we are. You know, it's so nice for a change to be the second youngest man on the show.
Hey, what the hell are you talking about?
Oh man, I don't know how virile you are, but I was just on Dancing with the Stars, the finals, and
with that jacket?
Just came from the set, that's why I'm all dressed like.
You wear that jacket? What's that jacket made out of? Pubic hair or what?
No, it came from a clown's pubic hair.
Ah, it seems like it. All blast colors, man.
Oh yeah, but I mean I'm still a senator. I'm still a thorn in the side of the President of the United States for the last 5 years, and I will continue to be that way for many years.
So, what is it true that you take mental reusal?
Oh, you name it, I've got it.
Yeah, well, of irregularity there in your bowels?
Let me tell you something. When I go to the doctor, and I have to fill out that thing, if you had mumps, if you had measles, if you had cancer, if you had heart attacks or anything, I just put one big X on everything.
I tell you what. Well, maybe Obamacare will help you out there, sir. Maybe Obamacare will help you with your pre-existing conditions.
Well, that's right. No.
How is that?
If Barack Obama tells me it's going to be sunny today, I'm going to go out with an umbrella and a raincoat just to spite him.
Okay. That's nice to know. So you're not down with Obamacare?
No, I'm not down with anything.
Are you down with OPP?
I have a backs to grind with Barack, and he, you know, I've been in the Senate for so long. I was a
Dinosaur, are you?
Oh, I'm a dinosaur. You're right. I thought I was there when the dinosaur.
You were born when Christ came out, right?
I was. That's me. And let me tell you, I was in a POW camp for many years, and I was in an enemy. I don't know what a man has to do. He becomes president. He's only senator for like 2 years, and then he becomes. Then he gets a Nobel Peace Prize, which is the easiest way anyone has ever gotten a Nobel Peace Prize. He just got elected president. I was a POW almost as long as Nelson Mandela, and I don't get anything.
I'll tell you what. What's the deal here? You've been approved about the new Secretary of State here. What seems to be the problem with that?
Secretary of State yet, Henry, and we're going to make sure she isn't.
Why is that?
Me and Senator Graham, Lindsey Graham of South Carolina, let me tell you what's going to happen. You know all about that thing that happened in Libya and Benghazi. It's a terrible, terrible thing. And the Obama administration just lied to everybody, and they sent this woman out, this Susan Rice, and she the Secretary of the UN for the United States, and she's a paid liar. I don't even know why we even have anything to do with the UN. And here she is, I don't even think he considered giving her the Secretary of State job to replace Hillary Clinton. But what happened was, once I started making a big fuss about it, he's the same name with me she shouldn't be his Secretary of State.
What can you do about it? You can't do squat.
Well, I'm very mad at. Well, I could filibuster. Nobody could talk.
Buster.
I've been talking for many years.
Listen, this guy can give you a
McCain. I'm talking and talking.
Hey.
I can't shut up until I lost breath.
This guy, back in 2008, they gave you a McCain buster, didn't they?
Yes, that's right. And let me tell you something. There is a woman that's very dear to me.
Who's that?
That I think should be the next Secretary of State.
I don't want to hear that.
Oh, she would make the best Secretary of State. She's from Alaska.
Is that right?
She used to be the governor of Alaska.
Yeah?
She was my running mate for vice president. She's very plain.
Let me ask you a question.
She could talk.
I gotta stop you a second.
And she could sing.
Now, I had an interview with that Benelax a few years ago. And I asked her,
McCain,
hold on a second. I had a bad interview with her, and I asked her if you all had anal sex together.
Well, that's, no. I have, you ever seen my wife? She's a very good looking woman.
You never anal sex?
Well,
I just wanted to know whether or not.
Let me tell you something. You said, I know what you're saying, and I'm glad you brought that up, because whenever somebody says that I had an affair with this woman or that woman, I never admit to it.
Did
I? I wanted to know it either, but I never admit to it.
Well, what the hell is up with Sarah Palin? You know, that's probably why you lost the
election.
That's why you lost the election. Well, I mean, what's up with that?
What's up with what? She would make a great Secretary of State. She could go. I mean, you should see she does. She can go to Germany.
What's her IQ? Is it true, Johnny, that you rejected her and told her that she doesn't have that she has the same brains as your nut that you live in Denae? Or Duane, whether that
Let me tell you something. I'm doing fine. You see my beautiful daughter on the Tonight Show all the time, Megan? And
is that right?
What I can do is you see her wonderful family, Sarah's wonderful family. I mean, and look at Obama. He only has two kids. And I don't
know. Let's get back to the meat and potatoes of the situation. Now, you're just talking a bunch of malarkey. What do you think you can do? Harsh, I'm talking. What do you think you can do concerning filibustering this woman here? You can't filibuster her. The person that does your makeup can't even do that right.
For 80 years old, I think I look fine. You know, I'm the oldest man I've ever run for president. You know, let me tell you something. The woman you like is Mrs. Bill Clinton, she's going to run in 2016, and she's going to be older than I was 4 years ago. So, don't But of all people, an old man like you,
should be. Let me tell you something. You don't know how old I am. You have no clue to know how old I am. So this interview is about you. Let's all get personal with Henry. Henry is very virile for the women. You don't need to know about that. Now you continue your dialogue, but don't get personal with Henry.
That white suit of yours. You used to be the ice cream man or something.
I'll give you some ice cream. Matter of fact, I'll spray it on your face.
Are you the man from Glad or something? That white suit on you?
Matter of fact, what's that? Is that cream up your butt cheeks or what? What's up going on there? That's Philadelphia's cream cheese?
No, that's Grecian formula.
Oh, okay. I got you.
It doesn't work that well.
I got you. I just got to set the record straight there. Now, is it true, Mr. McCain, that you got a problem here with Miss Sarah?
Not
you.
I have no problem with Sarah. Susan Rice is
Susan.
She's the ambassador to the UN, and used to be John Bolton. John Bolton, if my good friend Mitt was elected president, John Bolton would be the Secretary of State, and we wouldn't have this.
Your friend Mitt.
Susan Rice, let me tell you about Susan Rice. She is so despicable. She's such a big liar that I don't even eat rice anymore. When I go to a Chinese restaurant, all I have is chicken, sweet and sour chicken and cottage cheese.
Is that right?
But doesn't Condoleezza rice melt in your mouth?
Oh, Condoleezza rice? The French dead rice I like. I like the brown rice. Nothing crazy about Susan rice.
Hey, now listen here. Now,
what about Condoleezza rice?
Rice-a-roni is the biggest San Francisco treat. We know that.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, the rice-a-roni is the San Francisco treat. But yeah. Anyway.
That's true.
Okay.
We can agree on that.
All right, so let's get to the climax of the situation here. So what are you planning on doing? I mean, how are you going to stop this from happening?
Well, I was thinking of, taking my shirt off and just swinging it around in the chambers, and that'll distract, and then Lindsey Graham will probably do that Gangnam-style dance and everything, and that should work out, and then... In all the commotion, then we'll just throw some stink bombs here and there, and then we're just going to do this tag team match because we do have the majority in the Congress, but the Senate, we have to do what we can. We can just talk forever. And let me tell you something: if there's anything we Republicans can do, is talk. We're full of.
Let me tell you something about you Republicans. Wait a second. All you Republicans, all you don't know how to do is pass gas. Oh, the gas is coming out of our ass on the electric bill, basically. That's where the gas is coming from, not up here. Well, up here, too.
Yeah.
Because everything you guys say is equivalency of me taking a dump.
Well, you know what?
Let me ask you a question, John McCain. Have you ever examined your stools?
Oh, I do great. From my age.
Has Dr. Oz told you about the color scheme of your stools? If it's green, go back to England or whatever, and if it's brown, you're on time.
Well, that's definitely
time for a revolution.
Yes.
It's time for a revolution, yes. Yes, in fact, it's about time. We should get the Tea Party, and we should... I bet you the Tea Party could beat the hell out of the Occupy Walnut hippies in Central Park.
Now, why do you support those tea baggers? You want to get bagged?
The tea baggers want to stop taxes. They want to throw tea in the Boston Harbor. They want to...
Anal cavity is pretty damn loose down there, McCain.
They're the greatest.
Your anal cavity out there is pretty damn loose, I bet.
Well, I find it very strange that you are so insulting to old people. You are a disgrace to old people. I'm already...
Listen to me. Simply the facts. That's how we do it. Now, let me tell you something. Let me get off topic here. On Halloween... On a Halloween night, do you give the kids treats?
Yes, I give them. Speaking of Chinese food, whatever my wife's name, not Calista, I forgot what her name is. But anyway, Mrs. McCain.
Yes.
Her and I, we collect all the sweet and sour packets and all.
Right.
Soy sauce packets.
And you give them to the kids?
I give them to the kids. How did you know? The kids gotta know that the harsh reality is like they're not, the whole world is not gonna give them.
Listen here.
When they're
at least give them a cold or a cough and you give them some crutches.
Well, yeah.
There's some cough drops.
Well, we can do that, too.
You do?
That, too.
Okay. I'm a lucky charms, the blow pops.
See,
let me... A blow pop?
Yes, we could, but we would like Jolly Ranchers and Dum Dums. In fact, did you model for the Dum Dum lollipop?
Is that right? Model yet?
Top of your head.
Let me tell you something here. Now,
dandruff problems, because I've never seen a bald-headed man with dandruff before.
Let's see here. You don't know about Henry. Henry is very funky. It's very vital to it, virile. All the young ladies in their 20s love to get down with Henry. I have a list of people that I know, and hell, I'm even big in the Pentagon. They know about Henry. Henry is funky, and he's got it going on. And just one of these days, before I pass and kick the bucket, I will be the next president of the United States.
Well, you know, we could use men like you in the Department or the Pentagon or even in the Senate.
But I believe in sexual freedom. If you want to go ahead and do it to Mrs. Jones, whether she's married, you go right ahead and do it to her. If you want to go ahead and smoke that Cabanas, you go right ahead and smoke it.
Yeah, that's...
How do you believe in these states now with marijuana being legal? Are you for that, McCain? And do you smoke it?
Well,
or do you smoke penis?
Well, I mean, you couldn't get through the... You couldn't get through the 1960s without smoking it.
Yes.
You couldn't get through the
1960s. Well, when you smoke, does your eyes water up?
Oh, yeah.
You got all the secretion comes out?
Oh, yes, but that's...
You smoke penis?
No, I don't do that.
You don't smoke it?
No, don't...
You play with it?
What I did, I don't know what you did during the 1960s, but I was, while you were smoking pot and everything.
Let me tell you something.
I was actually in a POW camp, dying for my country. Luckily, you people, I survived. So now people like you up there got an earful from you, and I'm ready to talk. I have a lot to say.
So you were probed then, is that what you're trying to tell me?
I'm what?
You were probed.
When you're a prisoner, that's...
We interested in you. We've interested in the Chinese girl for China.
Yes. That's what I heard.
Sometimes.
What I told Yum Sum Ying. Yum Sum Ying, you know her?
No, I know Hu Fung Dung.
You fool her?
I know Hung Long.
She loved you long time.
Confucius say.
She loved you long time.
Yeah, Confucius say. Man who go to bed without... without a wiping butt, wake up with stinky hands.
Yes. So you've been reading the Bible pretty well, haven't you?
No, that's Confucius.
I thought Confucius was a scripture in the Bible.
No.
What I thought.
You should go to Glenn Beck's blackboard. He'll teach you about that.
Glenn Beck.
About history.
Is that right? Okay.
Not the real history, but he'll teach you about it.
So, hey, Mr. McCain, well, in final closing, what do you believe is going to happen then?
Well...
How do you feel the next 4 years are going to flow?
I think that the next 4 years, we're going to... I don't know who they're going to pick if they don't pick Susan Rice, but I think eventually they'll get...
It's an accident.
I think eventually they'll get Sarah Palin, Certainly, I mean, she owes me one, and I think she'd make a wonderful...
All right. Well, I'll tell you what, whatever you might think, I think you need to just I got to use a clothespin because I can smell some funky fungus in here.
Funky guy.
I'm feng shui. I'm feng shui. But anyway, I smell something down there. It's like cottage cheese or something to that effect.
Yes.
All right, well, anyway, Mr. McCain, I appreciate it. We're going to go ahead and go into a little chat here. Let's go back into that intro, and we'll be right back on the Gorgeous George Show. Thank you, Mr. McCain, for teaching me how not to think. I appreciate that.
Always glad to oblige.
Yes, you're an imbecile.
The fellow,
all right, let's go back to that lovely intro. We'll be right back here on the Gorgeous George.
Just when I've begun to get myself together, you waltz right in the door, just like you've done before, and wrap my heart round your little finger. Here you come again, just when I'm about to make it work. you. You look into my eyes and lie those pretty lies. And pretty soon I'm wondering how I came to doubt you. All you gotta do is smile and smile, and therefore my defenses. Just leave it up to you, and in a little while you're messing up my mind.
On the Gorgeous George Show. My name is Kay Lazar, and we have Vinnie Mac here. How you doing, Vinnie Mac?
Yes, welcome to the McNeil and Laren Hour. and this is McNeil, and I guess I'm Laren. I don't even know who does what.
McNeil is retired. McNeil. that was Henry. Anyway, let me tell you something. People want to know. Who was that masked man?
Yeah, who was that masked man?
Let me tell you something. When you're acting with those masks that George makes me wear all the time, it's like wearing the skin mask from the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. The wall just gets unbearable in there, and you're forced to be funny at any moment there. But anyway, it's been. How did you enjoy the Thanksgiving holiday?
I had a great time. My big sister fixed a big Thanksgiving feast. I enjoyed all the football and TV, and then I got stuck in traffic.
Traffic in town?
No, in Baltimore and in Washington. I got stuck in both cities.
It's a big travel weekend. Did you buy anything on Black Friday?
Oh, heck no. The only thing I bought on Black Friday was sleep. That was it.
I went on Black Friday. On Black Friday, I went to the Dollar Tree.
Uh-huh.
And then they told me every day here is Black Friday. I mean, I said, do you have any bargains here? So, the dollar?
Dollar? Yeah.
I once got arrested for shoplifting at the Dollar Tree. And $7. Filled my pockets full of stuff. $7. I got arrested for.
Oh, shame on you, Kevin.
What was I going to say? I bought a tablet. I went to a store that's not that. It's like not much better than Dollar Tree.
Okay.
And I bought an $80 tablet. And I don't know how the hell it works. you need the internet.
Yes.
But I found out something about these tablets. Now, if you have a laptop or desktop computer, you know what those are. So I get the tablet, and it's basically like a girlfriend. Your laptop, you're married to. You have to lug it around. You have to be. But your tablet.
Put a ring on it.
It came with a rubber band, let me tell you. And so the tablet, the tablet's dependent on the internet, so and taking forever to do. I think the remnants of that last skit is still around.
Yeah, Henry's still around. Henry's still around. I was going to try to catch up with Henry earlier, but I know he left.
Yeah.
And I was going to ask him about my family was arguing up in Maryland about Maryland leaving the ACC for the Big Ten.
Yes, isn't that the Terps?
Yes, I fell out of my seat.
and I hear Henry, and I gotta get a hold of him.
Yeah,
he's been eating so much of that turkey, and I wanted to ask Henry, what did he think about it, and should we bring Marilyn back to the ACC?
He looks kind of like a turtle, you know, he has that turtle head. He has that
turtle type head. He's related to the turtle, so we can ask him them type of questions, but that'll be probably for another time.
Yes. So, yeah. Well,
yes, it has that gravitational pull.
All right. So that's, I guess, the big sports news.
Yes.
Also,
what
else happened over the weekend? You know, never die on the Thanksgiving weekend, because you know, I haven't heard a whole lot about Larry Hagman died.
But
when you die on the holiday weekend, people don't know about it until a week later. But he actually got a good. He got a second life out of that second litter.
Yes, he did. That was one of my favorite actors of all time. Yeah. I loved I Dream of Jeannie, and I didn't like Dallas, but he made Dallas.
He's good.
Yes.
Anyway. We have a special guest now.
Yes, is Henry back?
Better than Henry.
All right.
He was teaching a anger management class to Halle Berry's boyfriend, but he's back. So here he is. The star. No, he's not here yet. He's still teaching, evidently, that guy.
Oh. I'm probably going to get a psychiatrist after this.
Well, actually, wait a minute. I think Halle Berry needed. And who got beat up?
I don't know.
I think Halle Berry, that guy.
Let me tell you who really got beat up. It's the people who listened to that story. That's who got beat up.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, let me tell you something. I've been at the other, you know, trying to. Every time I walk out, let me tell you something. When you do this show, it's like when you walk out, it's like walking the gauntlet. All the people throw rocks at you. It's all like being in the stockades in Jamestown.
It's like, how long is your sentence? Our sentence is for 1 hour. We're doing this show. Now I hear some dance music, but
all right, here he is, the man you've been waiting for, Mr. Gorgeous George Valentine.
And the people split. And only one Gorgeous George. Woo! Who does that? George. Just stop it.
All right. That's where we roll. How goes it, baby? How was your turkey? Was your turkey good?
Stuffed to the gills.
Alright. Where's that blue ball back there? Is that blue ball back there?
Blue balls?
Blue balls. All right. Yeah, the blue ball's back there. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, it's Gorgeous George, and here's my grandpa, Amin Valentine. Give a good shot at Amin there. Get a little close up Amin. He's a good old man. You know, he's a man that used to be with us here a long time ago. And we're going to challenge his spirit tonight. And he's going to come out, and we're going to challenge his spirit. So we're going to see his spirit coming in this ball here. We were supposed to have a psychic on tonight, and get a little close-up of Mean right there. Okay. We were supposed to get a psychic on tonight. It didn't happen. We were supposed to get our female co-host, the porn star from Williamsburg. That didn't happen. And we're supposed to get another girl that was supposed to come on tonight, and that didn't happen either. This is my grandpa, Amin Valentine.
We went all the way to the 1950s to get this guy.
That's right. I'm going to
challenge
anyone in the 21st century.
I'm gonna challenge his spirit right now.
19th century.
Hey, Grandpa, you there? Can I hear you? We're trying to challenge your spirit. All right, get close up of our Grandpa. He's trying to talk.
Stop waking me up. I'm trying to sleep.
All right, listen now. Now, Grandpa, you know back, you know, Dad used to give you Playboy magazines to get you excited. Now, how was that? You were really excited by that, or what? Tell me about it.
I can't really discuss all the details entailed there about Playboy.
Yes.
You know about my genitals.
Your genitals?
You have to have to excuse me on that kind of level there. I was too busy working and taking care of your mama.
Yeah. Well, now listen, Grandpa. Don't embarrass me. You don't have my own TV show now. You have it, don't you?
Well, congratulations! What's TV?
A TV show. I mean, we've been on for 18 solid years. You know,
radio with pictures.
Yeah, it's like a magazine with fur.
It's more like Telegraph with pictures.
Yes. Now I'm challenging you. I'm bringing you.
I never could afford one of those TV box thingies.
Yeah, the box thing. Okay.
We I think in his day they had like a shoebox with a camera in the back.
All right,
So
how's it up there in the sky? Is it pretty good, the man in the sky? How's it?
It's pretty chilly up here. You always see the sun. You never lose sight of it. It's okay. Always in your face.
Right, I got you. I got
it's
you.
Never nighttime.
Well, at least you're not below, which I'm glad. You're not below.
Hell is a crazy thing. I was there one time, and a goddamn volcano spit me out.
Okay. Gotcha. So tell me about heaven itself. I mean, explain the pearly gates to me. I mean, how is the pearly gates? I mean,
pearly gates? I haven't seen no pearly gates. The only thing I've ever seen is the white gates of the moon.
You mean heaven is the moon? I think it's said
that. Okay, all right.
You got all these craters up there, and you can bounce around. Every time you land on the ground, you bounce right back up. You got no gravitation,
right.
So it's just hard for you to stay close to the planet.
Grandpa, we're losing you. I'm trying to challenge your spirit here. Put it back with us for a second. Put it back with us here. How we're trying to challenge the spirit here. All right, listen. And Kevin's rubbing the your head.
Rubbing the frame.
Grandpa Amin, tell me, is there Putang up there in the heavens?
Putang?
Yes, Putang.
What is Putang?
You know what Putang is? Punanery.
Punanery?
The greenery.
You're talking about the double lips on the bottom? It's always a different color down there for some reason.
Well, I just want to know, if it's grassy and if it's bushy and if it's... always good to come to.
The old ladies I get these days, they still got hair down there the color of mine.
All right. Well, Grandpa, listen.
They're kicking old school.
I'm trying my damnedest, you know. I want to win the lottery. Is that ever going to happen?
I wouldn't keep your pants off for that one.
Something. If he wins the $400 million tomorrow,
yeah.
He'll keep his pants off the rest of his life.
Well, what do I care? It's not like you can share it with me.
Well, let me know something, though. So, I mean, you're in a good place then, right? I mean, seriously, you're in a good place?
Yeah, you know, if you consider whisping around the winds of the moon and whisping around the mountains of the planet, I guess I'm in a really good spot. I can see all the bitches.
So there are bitches up there then, right? They're good, nice-looking bitches up there.
No, I'm talking about looking at the ones around the Richmond, VA area.
Look down on them. Let me tell you.
I'm rubbing it here.
No, let me tell you.
How's Grandma doing?
Okay.
Grandma? I haven't seen her in 100 years.
Okay.
That is heaven.
Okay. Do you have any exams up there? Do they give you any oral exams or any prostate exams up there in heaven?
I'm going to ask you a serious freaking question.
What's that?
How in the world can a spirit get a prostate exam? We don't even have a freaking body.
I don't know, man. I just want to know. It's the same way on Earth, you know? I mean, I just wanted to ask.
I'll tell you what. When I get into a buddy, and I'll let you know when I get a prostate exam. I've never even heard of one.
Grandpa, any closing words for the audience and for me and for everybody else?
You already had your final words. Any more words?
Well, I'll tell you, just relax and take life easy, because it don't last forever.
But the grass is always green on the other side, is that correct?
Well, that depends on what color green you're talking about.
All right.
Well, thank you.
Thank you, Grandpa.
Hello.
Thank you, Grandpa. We got to get right back.
He's a mean man.
A nice man. Okay, that was good. That was good. That was good in there. I mean, give me that. All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's Gorgeous George in effect, not Rex in effect, because all I want to do is run my zoom zoom and that boom boom and shake that bunk or shake that ass. All right, so anyway, we are looking at, we're looking at the future, man. Now, there's a reason.
The future is blue balls.
I know. It's milk and magnesia, actually. The color of milk and magnesia. We're looking at this, and we're trying to figure out, because, you know, the Mayan calendar in December, the world, everybody's going to do, the world's coming to an end. So we're gazing to see if, in fact, sometime in the next few weeks, if the world is coming to an end. So, I mean, we're looking. I mean, Kevin, what do you see?
Well, I think from what a lot of secessionists are talking about, with Obama being reelected, I think the world is coming to an end.
You do?
I don't think so, but they seem to think so.
Well, and, but they're looking at the center core right there. Well, hold on a second. Good God, I see somebody just going to town on that girl. What the hell is going on here? Okay. He's like just banging her to that kingdom come. Okay, I'm going to shake it up here.
What is that, a porn site?
It must be a porn site.
You get internet porn.
Okay. Listen, once you got it, Kevin. All right. I see Confucius. He's on a broomstick. Look at that. Confucius flying on a broomstick. All right. All right, ladies and gentlemen, no substitute. It's Gorgeous George. Gorgeous George is in the house. Tuesday night. You never know when Gorgeous George will come on. Have we ever been on a Tuesday night? We've never been on a Tuesday night.
This is an unlisted show. If you're watching this show, it's not listed in the. If you were changing the channel, you got the show. Consider yourself lucky.
That's right.
Because you just stumbled. This is like the.
You never, never, never know when the Gorgeous George show will be blessing your camera, blessing your TV. Tuesday night. It's the first for all. Tuesday night. You know, it's what it is, and we're here.
Yeah.
All right. We have Mr. Bo in the house tonight. He was on last year. He's in the house right now. Yeah. We'll try to get you a mic.
No, come on over here.
Well, yeah. We'll get you on here. We'll get you on.
And now here he is, Bo.
All right.
Here you go.
Put the mic on.
Hi, Bo.
Take that mask, if you would, Kevin, on the ground, and there you go. Thank you, sir. All right. There you go. So what's going on, man? What's happening?
What's happening with your sir?
What be going on? How's the world treating you?
The world is treating me like, the world doesn't even know me.
Doesn't even know you?
Doesn't even know me. I really can't say anything too bad.
Can't say anything too bad? Okay. Well, I don't know. I think the world is doing good. I think these whack jobs are thinking the world's coming to an end. What you guys say about that?
I think Obama's doing a great job.
Okay. He's doing a top job, right?
Yeah. He's doing a great job. I mean, he's helping out the unemployed by giving them extra money for being unemployed. And you know, because of the poor economy and everything, they can't help it. We got so many extra people in the states these days.
That's right.
So he's doing a great job.
I think he's doing a top job. And, yes, I think he's the best. He was the better than the alternative.
I think Lee's doing a great job in North Korea, too.
Who?
Lee.
Lee? Okay.
That guy, Lee.
Okay. What about the corpse of Mussolini and Hitler? Are they doing good? Are they still doing good?
Who are they?
The corpse of Mussolini and the corpse of Hitler. Are they still doing good?
I have not seen those corpses.
You have not seen them? Okay. I didn't know if they were still around or whatnot. They had the corpse of Saddam and Bin Laden. How are they doing?
I don't know. I heard they were blown in bits and pieces.
Saddam and Bin Laden just blown up in smithereens.
Yeah, they're part of the mountain decay.
I got you. Well, anyway, so let's talk about it now. What's going on with you as far as your music? is concerned. What's new in the
music? Well, I have introduced another music video to my channel called Everybody Needs a Girl to Love.
Okay.
It's actually kind of hot. Some people might say it's a little too hot.
Okay. Hot in what way?
Well, there's some lap dances going on, and you know, there's some a dime piece and another dime piece and another dime piece in it. I mean, you just can't miss all the dime pieces in it, that's for sure.
Mm-hmm. All right, let's hear a little bit of it. Might as well.
Everybody needs a girl to love. You want me to?
Let's hear it. Let's go here.
You want a live version of it?
Let's do a live version of it. Yes.
All right. Here's a little bit. One, two, three sexy girls in a row, stripping for the dollar, taking off the clothes, shaking that booty, make my big heart grow. Show me what you got, baby, I wanna know. If you got the moves, honey, yeah, you make me moan. Suck a little harder, honey, yeah, you make me groan. Love me all night till 6 a.m. Everybody needs to go to love all night long. Everybody needs to go to love all night long. Everybody needs to go to love all night long. Everybody needs to go to love all night long. I what you have a need for, a girl. Opposite attraction wanted in my world. I what you have a need for, a girl. Sexual attraction applied to my world. I have what you have a need for, a girl. I have what you have a need for, a girl. Everybody need to go to love all night long. Everybody need to go to love all night long. Everybody need to go to love all night long. Everybody need to go to love all night long. Ha ha. One, two, three, hot mommies in a row. No fat hoochie mama's messing up my flow. Get it done right, baby, putting on a show. Give me that loving like you just don't know. If you get the moves, yeah, you gotta get blown. Make me love me, baby, get it all night long. Everybody needs to go to love all night long. Everybody needs to go to love all night long. Everybody needs to go to love all night long. I what you have a need for, a girl. Opposite attraction wanted in my world. I have what you have a need for, a girl. Sexual attraction applied to my world. I have what you have a need for, a girl. I have what you have a need for, a girl. Everybody need to go to love all night long. Everybody need to go to love all night long. Everybody need to go to love all night long. Everybody need to go to love all night long.
All right. All right.
Hey!
Yeah, there you go. There you go. That's good. That's good. That's pretty damn good. So now, when are we going to get you on vinyl? Or when are we going to get you on the iPod?
That is coming up shortly. Working on getting a CD put out with a short album. It's going to have four other songs on it.
Yeah.
And we're going to put them all together and sell them and disperse them that way.
Okay.
And I hope
so.
I
be on vinyl, be on iPod, be on you know, be out there for everybody to
MTV.
Well,
MTV,
of course, video.
It should be within the next 4 or 5 months, hopefully.
Okay. Let's get that old one you did real fast. Let's hear that again about a hoe. Everybody needs a hoe. What's that?
Oh, he wants to hear that one.
Let's go ahead. Let's do it.
That's got the same beat to it.
Okay.
It's
a little different, isn't it?
A little different.
Okay. Let's do it.
Okay.
But that's where we need some filler because this girl didn't show up tonight. Let's go ahead.
One, two, three, line them up in a row. Pull out a fat tree, roll a blunt for show. Fat or narrow, how y'all want to cut? Licking up a line off a sweet ass butt. Oh shit, some fella to crack. What? I'll get that, my little party slut. Blowing up smoke in my little bitty hut. Smoking sweet ass, drawing a sweet ass blunt. Damn, let me lick some of this off for. I lost my little. Because there's probably a lot of female listeners. A lot of them can't stand that.
Well, you know, that is what it is.
I just said it anyway.
Kevin, what are you doing to the camera? Messing the camera up? We done. Alright, that was the. We're going to move that camera just a little bit over here. Okay. Even a little bit more. I shouldn't have to tell you that, Kevin. Okay, now. Yeah, move it back this way. Okay. Move it back this way. Okay. Rock the boat. Don't rock the boat. Okay.
Rock the boat, baby.
Rock the boat.
Don't rock the boat, baby. Rock the boat.
Rock on with your bad self. Rock the boat. We can't go on together with suspicious minds. We can't go on together with suspicious minds. Honey, this is Elvis.
I do like that song.
Elvis is in the house. Honey, you lied when you told Elvis you go down on him. And he had no cause doubt you. Now, I don't want to hear any more lies. They go on sleeping without you. Now your tits are bare with breast milk all around. And honey, you don't go down on me. I gotta pull your panties down.
That's good. It gives himself.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
All this music is making me crazy. Yeah. I'm going crazy.
Yeah.
Oh! I can't believe he's putting that.
Kevin's milking the little cow right now. So anyway, so yeah, that is how it rolls. It's good to hear what's going on. We are back on. We've been on. This is week four. We're on right now, and we're on Tuesday nights, and we're going to be on, maybe we might be back on Wednesday, we might be back on Tuesday. You just never know when we're going to be on. Right now, it's Tuesday night for this week. We have a band coming on, hopefully. I don't want to jinx it. I'm not going to say who the band is. But
the Rolling Stones.
You said it, but no, that's not the band. But we have a band coming up on the last week. We have two more shows coming up. So we plan to do it with ease and make it happen. I like to say, though, that, you know, with all the shows that we've done, we plan to do a movie. Now, this movie that's coming up is going to be The Christmas Carol, the gorgeous George Christmas Carol, and we're going to have to take a weekend to shoot it. And it's going to be a phenomenal movie. I'm going to have three ghosts that visit me, and I'm going to be...
Are you going to have the Ghost of Christmas Past?
Yeah, it's the Ghost of Christmas Past, the Ghost of Christmas Present.
I don't know where that came from.
And the Ghost of Christmas Future. And these three ghosts are, you know, I'm going to be like not wanting to do the show anymore. And I'm going to be like wanting to quit the show. And these three ghosts are going to tell me what it would be like without the Gorgeous George Show. And it would be horrible for you folks out there without the Gorgeous George Show. Because we know that if it was ratings, we know. If it was all ratings, you know, let's face it. I mean, I don't want to toot my own horn, but toot toot.
It sounds to me like God might show up on your show.
Well, you know, and I'm looking forward to that.
Billy Graham?
I'm looking forward, you know, Billy Graham and his crackers, you know? Bring them on, you know?
Oral Roberts and his peculiarities.
I can't have oral because oral gets too oral for the majority. So we don't want to have that going on. But we're going to have some of the dignitaries on. We might have Apostle Paul on, St. Peter. And all the disciples.
We've had plenty of Peters on this show. When are we going to get to?
Well, I don't know. I mean, it's...
Too much.
Yeah. Well, you see, that's just the way it is. But when you have lemons, what do you do?
You know, if you have some live tulips on the show, then that just might inspire some female tulips to come on the show.
Live what?
Tulips.
Die live tulips?
My favorite flower.
Live tulips, okay. Well... You know, it's a grassy knoll.
Any greenery in here.
Well, we'll get some greenery soon enough. It's not like we've ever had greenery.
Pink?
We've had greenery. We've had pink, you know. And I'm not talking about the pig. But we've had pink.
Well, we don't want anything that's necessarily yellow, but pink is definitely good.
Yeah, well, yellow is, you know, ganja. Ganja.
Lips. You know. Pink.
Greenery.
Yeah, well, that's...
Who asked for greenery?
What asking for... So, but we're asking for this, and we're asking for that.
He's pulling Christmas
stuff.
Early.
Yeah, so anyway, but we got lots coming on here, and Kim, what the hell are you doing?
Circus act. I'm balancing.
You're balancing?
I'm a balancing actor.
Okay.
He's going to hit me in the back of the head with that.
Yeah, he's going to do that, I guess, yes. All right, so that is the way it is, and Vinny Mal is announced.
This is in Colorado now.
Yeah, it is, and in Washington, too, and a few other states. Will it ever be legal here? That's the question. Soon enough, probably. Soon enough. Vince is in the house also, too. What's going on, Mr. Vince?
Nothing.
All right.
Just hanging. I didn't know that I was on American Idol, and I thought I'll play Simon and say y'all both sucked, okay. Because Simon always says that everybody sucks.
Right.
But then again, Simon...
But you and Simon have something in common, Vince.
What's that?
You both swallow.
I thought you said that we both made millions.
You both swallow.
Simon says something.
You do the opposite.
Something is a singer is fair, then they're probably great.
Anyway.
Well, this was better than American Idol.
You did a Bing Crosby one time before.
Yes, he did.
Let's say a Bing Crosby because it's a Christmas festival.
Yes.
You know.
Oh, that the one is. I can only do part of it because I don't have a very good memory. Yeah. Okay. I smoked way too much pot in my life.
Okay. Who doesn't? Go ahead.
That's. I'm dreaming
of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know, where the treetops glistened and children listened to the snowflakes as they danced across the snow. And I'm dreaming I'm gonna walk across this floor, just because I can't remember any more of these words.
So does everybody in Hollywood.
I'd live to the ending and now say goodbye. And then you will know why I go home and cry.
Yay! Very good.
Right. This is a sublime moment there.
Very good.
And you know what I gotta do? You know what I'm gonna do right now, right?
No.
You know what I'm gonna do right now?
Chestnuts
roasting over an open rack. Jack Frost nipping at that puss. Yuletide guys with their eyes on a glow will find it hard to sleep tonight, cause they know that GG is on his way.
That sounds so feminine.
Filling up all the pantyhose and stockings with his sleigh.
Whee!
And every mother's mother and sister is going to spy to see if Gigi can really get it up. So I'm offering this simple phrase from kiddies from 1 to 2020. Although it's been said many times, many ways, merry together Christmas, merry Christmas.
I messed up, sorry.
Merry Christmas. Say it again. Merry Christmas to Nat King Cole can't do it better than me. That's where we got all the hobbledoo. Oh my God, let's yank him. Oh my God, he's being profane. Yank him.
Yankee.
No.
Okay.
I'm gonna give
chestnuts
it.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire.
Silent night.
Merry Christmas.
Oh my God, what's going on here?
Oh,
oh,
I'm sorry.
All right, we got 2 minutes left in this circus, ring circus. We are the Gorgeous George Show. When we're given lemons, you know what we do? We make lemonade.
We make hot dogs.
When we're given prunes, we make perlicious fluids. Baby, there's one Mona Lisa, one Leaning Tower of Pisa, and there's only one Gorgeous George. Believe it.
Ring a ding ding.
Or not.
Ring a ding ding.
Next Tuesday night, 10:30.
Put it in your ring.
Maybe.
Might be Saturday. It might be Sunday. You just never
Merry
know.
Merry Clinton.
I never know. I'm going to heal you.
Yeah.
And stay tuned because there'll be more healing in the next 2 weeks, baby.
I know. Hey, he's gone.
That's right.
He's gone. He's ready for the next show.